identity, possession and maintenance. So to get those resources, we have to earn. To earn, we have to learn. So this is the ladder of civilization or ladder of management. So products increase by expansion, and resources are to be increased. And to increase the resources, the methodology of earning must be maintained. For which there must be a system of learning. This is the second ladder, apart from clothing, shelter, and other things, etc. So what do you mean by expansion? Expansion is manifold. Expansion means expansion due to evolution, civilization, migration and trade, colonization, population increase. Then expansion due to maturity, development and progress in science and technology. This has increased a lot of requests in the society, which has created a new race. What is a new race known as? It is known as a demand race and desire race. The more desire is running, the demand is also running. The more the desire is running, demand is running, and demand is running, desire is running. So by a mutual lock and a mutual dependability, the desire as well as the demand that has an aimless race and continuously running without having proper destination, without having proper even deserving nature. So this is the status now. We are going to start learning or thinking about the art of life management. So in this base, in this expansion area, now it is our duty to understand as well as we have to equip ourselves with the demands and desires, where to control, where to augment, where to process, which to avoid. This type of prudential, this type of sagacious study of the situation and balancing one's own equilibrium and also catering to the needs of one's real life and also showing a pathway to others, it is known as life management now. So life management, it starts with two models. One is a fertile model, second is a fascination model. What is fertile model? If there is knowledge, if there is quality, if there is work, if there is opulence. If you imitate that and cultivate the same thing inside you, that is a fertile model. If there is mere status, comfort and style of life, without imitating the other requisites that are there, on which the foundation of their development is installed. If you just copy a person's status, comfort and other things and strive to get those things, that is a fascination model. Now the era is running only with fascination model, without cultivating the fertility of deserving nature and qualifying one's own self to get eligibility and procurability and withstandability of the resources, the affluential status. One person is blindly just after the fascinations. That is the present model. So the fascination model must be converted. I delivered a lecture on dream and reality of national security. And before talking about national security, I told that dream and reality, they are not different from each other. A person who is energetic, his dream is a pre-status for his reality. And reality is the mature status of his dream. And for a person who is hypnotic or artistic, his life will run only in dreams. So somebody asked about national security, how you are going to make this dream a reality? Then I told that I am not going to make your dream a reality. You people, due to lack of integration and proper methodology of approach, you are making this reality of national security a dream. So everything is possible. It may take some time, it may take mega transformation, mass renaissance, which may be made by the trampling of these ugly elements and ugly heads under the titanic feet of a tremendous and turbulent energy. So that turbulent source was to emerge in the society by our contemplation, execution and integrity. That's what it is. So to start with the human life, he starts with his family. As an individual, he has his family, his parents. Then the family is made, that is the wife and children, which he creates, which he assembles. That is his own family. Then he has his associates, relations and other friends. So this is known as sub-society. First, each and every human being is connected with sub-society as an individual, then with his family, the parenthood, then with his wife and children, then the relations and everything. And even now, they have more affinity towards possessions and pets. Pets are also now part of the family. And they love more the possessions rather than the parents and other people. So this thing is known as sub-society. A limited portion of the society in which the person is attached. And second thing is the mega society or the broader society or the wider society. In this wider society, We see lot of people. We are living living environment, we are having learning environment, and we are having professional environment where we earn and settle our lives. So academic, professional, and neighborhood. Neighborhood means where we have connections, where we have mutual discussions, where we have transactions, where we have mutual service exchanges. That is known as neighborhood, living environment. That is also second society. Then we have learning environment like the school, colleges, and tuition center. Then we have also professional environment. Then matrimonial environment, I have already told. That is also a form of sub-society. These are small clusters. Unless we understand these things and there are specific difficulties, to manage the life is just to write in a book and read it loud, and it cannot produce anything practically. So these are the various clusters of the society. Then the third society is a very big society with a lot of odds, with a lot of cleavages and disparities. We have a society which is being fragmented in names of language, in names of parties, in names of caste and race, in names of regions and religions. So it is a mega society or it is a wider society. And there are two problems. If you belong to the same clan or same group, it will create jealousy, friction between like-minded people or like-located people. That is known as homogeneous friction and heterogeneous friction. If a person belongs to the same caste, any person belonging to the same caste, instead of developing affinity, he may develop jealousy, which may result in hostility and disturbance. It is known as homogeneous friction. And naturally, if even homogeneous friction is there, heterogeneous friction is inescapable. So, due to the behavioral mismanagement of emotions of living beings, even if a person belongs to his own kind, he is subjected to turmoil. Even if a person is different, this emerges from jealousy to hostility, that from hatredness to hostility. But both the thing ends in hostility only. So it is a social error, it is a psychological error, it is a systemic error. So unless a person knows about all of these things and management issues, he cannot come for management at all. So what is management? Innumerable explanations have been given for management, but contextually, simply, as well as exhaustively, I want to give a definition for this. Number one, anything will move only by a driving force which is in the form of resources. That might be internal resources, external resources, individual resources, instrumental resources, technical resources, collective resources, subtle resources, tangible resources, whatever it may be. How to get the resources? What to do for the resources? What to do with the resources? And how to manage or how to exist without the resources? These three things are the questions for which the answer is management. What to do for the resources? What to do with the resources? And how to exist in spite of the absence of the so-called distinct or determined resources? And there are some interim stages between these three major questions. Between with and without, there are two things. One is inefficiency, second thing is insufficiency. Even if you possess something, that may be inefficient, that may be insufficient. Even adversity comes in between with and without. We cannot either say that we are having this or we are not having this. We are having this thing, but in adversity. So management is a skill. It is a masculine skill of a person's culmination of psycho-intellectual and spiritual sturdy, as well as the robust nature of a person's execution skill, by which a person can understand sociological, psychological, and ecological factors and derive at a conclusion in which the person is prosperous or at least safe. This is known as management. So management deals with the issues of for the resources, with the resources, and without the resources, even in cases of insufficiency, inefficiency, and adversity. The qualities that are required, the four pillars for management, according to Shastras,